Would you like to learn about the process for designing a cloud or enterprise architecture? If so, this video is for you. This video is another episode in our series about the cloud architecture process and enterprise architecture process. In this video, we will be discussing change management. Specifically, we will introduce Phase H of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. Phase H is all about change management, which is critical from both a systems availability perspective and making sure that the changes support the organization's needs. At GoCloud Careers, we are a member of the Open Group, and we leverage the TOGAF framework as it provides a structured and repeatable approach to designing cloud architectures and enterprise architectures that drive digital transformation. We like the TOGAF framework as it's an industry standard, which is used by major players in the cloud and enterprise architecture space, like IBM, Microsoft, Dell, Intel, VMware, Accenture, PricewaterhouseCooper, Deloitte, Cognizant, Capgemini, and so many other elite technology and consulting organizations. If you haven't seen the other TOGAF videos on developing an architecture vision, developing the business architecture, developing the data architecture, developing the technology architecture, finding opportunities and solutions, migration planning, or implementation governance, you can find them below in the description of this video. Now we'll be discussing Phase H of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. To begin, what is change management? Change management is about how changes affect the organization and how to make changes in the most effective manner. Change management is about examining how any proposed changes will affect different parts of the organization. Businesses are highly complicated systems that involve people, processes, and technology. Now, for cloud architects and enterprise architects, it's critical to understand that what seems like a simple change in technology can have a profound impact on the entire organization. Here are just a few examples of the things to consider from a change management process. How will a change to the network made at 4 p.m. affect production systems? At what time of the day will changes have the least financial impact to the organization? How will this new application for the sales team affect the finance and accounting departments? How do we integrate the systems from a company the business just acquired? That's why change management is so critical. A business has so many systems and they are all connected, and a change to any system can impact the entire organization, otherwise known as an enterprise. Now, what are the reasons that cause changes to occur? Well, business is not static, and there will be constant enhancements and changes to meet market needs. Here are some of the examples which would cause changes to the architecture to need to occur. Now, by architecture, we are referring to business architecture, data architecture, and technology architectures. The enterprise may purchase another company or change strategic directions, which will cause a change to the architecture. There may be a problem that needs fixing, either a business problem or a technology problem. There may be a new technology that can give the business a competitive advantage. While the architecture is being deployed by the engineering team, a problem may be discovered and that needs to be modified. There are even times when implementations are planned and then there becomes a shortage on a critical product or a critical service. Or there can be new regulations or rules that affect the business and how it will need to operate in the future. Now let's discuss the process for change management. First, please understand, there are many established frameworks for change management, and many of them work well. For example, there's PRINCE2, ITIL, and so many others. There are even special management consultants who focus on change management and consulting companies that have their own frameworks. And honestly, any of these could be used. Now, before we talk about the approaches to change management, let's talk quickly about the reasons for change management, meaning the drivers. First, there could be a strategic, top-down, directed change, usually to enhance or create new capability or function inside of the organization. There could also be bottoms-up changes. Usually these are to correct or enhance capabilities of an organization's operations or infrastructure. There are also experience with previous incremental architectures that are still being deployed that may need to be changed or modified along the way. So when we talk about the change management process, you know, we talk about typically using established frameworks, but TOGAF has made some great recommendations for change management in the enterprise architecture space, and we feel they could be integrated into any of these other change management processes. Specifically, TOGAF actually has a nice classification of changes, and it also suggests whether they should go through an entire change management process or a complete new iteration of the architecture development cycle. Here are the TOGAF change management classifications. The classifications are simplification changes, incremental changes, and re-architecting changes. Simplification changes are about simplifying or reducing the architecture, and it's often to cut costs. These are generally easy and can be managed by the organization's standard change management process. Incremental changes. These are about making small improvements. These can often be managed by the change management methods. Now, if the change will impact several stakeholders or a big part of the organization, then it should go through a complete architecture development cycle, not change management. Re-architecting changes. These are typically big changes, and they really need to go through a complete architecture development cycle, not change management. Effective change management is a critical component of the cloud architecture process as well as the enterprise architecture process. And change management is critical to assure alignment between the business needs and the technology systems. I talked about simplification changes and re-architecting changes, but here's a different way you can think about how the change management process works versus an architecture redesign. If the change that you want to make impacts multiple stakeholders, and that means typically multiple departments, then it likely needs an architecture redesign, not simple change management. If it only impacts one stakeholder, or typically one department, then change management can be used. If the change can be allowed under a dispensation, then it is likely a candidate for change management. If there is a change that is significant for the business strategy, then it may need an architectural redesign, not simple change management. If the change is due to a new technology, then change management may be all that's necessary. And these are a few examples of guidelines of deciding between change management and architectural redesign. Of course, this is a high-level overview. If you'd like to have a deeper understanding of this, please make sure to look at our training content. The link is in the description below. To learn how to get your first cloud architect job, please download the free ebook and join us for the free webinar on how to become the ultimate cloud architect. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like and please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified about cloud architecture and enterprise architecture videos and training to assist you in your cloud architect or enterprise architect career. I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.